welcome to a new reading vlog. Today we are going to be participating in the 24-hour Rory Gilmore Readathon. This is my first Rory Gilmore 24-hour Readathon. I honestly never do well on these, but I'm gonna try my hardest. And yeah, I have to admit, I'm a recent fan of the Gilmore Girls. I watched the show during quarantine and I was an emotional wreck by the end. I may or may not show a picture because the picture is way too... it's me at my lowest. So yeah, anyway, but that was me when I finished the show and I did not know what to do. I think this show is just so lighthearted and it's so happy, and I'm excited to one day rewatch it. And for the readathon, I'm going to have to watch some episodes, so I'm excited about that. It is 9 a.m. and I wish I had woken up earlier. I did not. We're not gonna dwell on it. But yeah, I already finished one of the challenges. I had breakfast. I think one of the challenges is to have a Look Diner inspired meal. I had my chocolate chip pancakes, and yeah, now onto the books. I checked the list and I have a lot of books to go. I mean, I have like 38 read only, so yeah. But as to the books that I will be reading, I'm going to start with Mrs. Dalloway by Virginia Woolf. This book, I know that it spans a day only, so it's kind of interesting to see that. And yeah, I'm kind of scared because I read to the lighthouse and I was so bored, and I took like a week or two reading it, and it was like 170 pages. So this one is, I think, kind of, yeah, 194 pages. So yeah, this is the exact same edition that Rory Gilmore has on the show, which is kind of cool. I would show a picture. But yeah, and because this is used, it is annotated by someone else, which low-key I kind of like. It's like when Jess annotated that copy of Howl to Rory. Yeah. Yeah, I'm gonna shut up now. I'm gonna start reading because we need to finish this by the end of the day. Everyone, a little update. It's about 4 o'clock in the afternoon and I just finished Virginia Woolf's Mrs. Dalloway. This book was boring. I expected it. I had a little hard time kind of reading it. I found an audiobook on YouTube, which I will link below if you are interested. I think the audiobook is great. It's free, so yeah. But this book basically follows the character of Mrs. Dalloway during the span of a day. Although it doesn't really follow just Mrs. Dalloway. We get to follow the people around her, her husband, her child, and many other people in the town. So it does explore a lot of mental health, especially after the post World War II. And yeah, that's it. But I wasn't really invested in the characters, and because of that, I found the story to be extremely boring. And I saw a review of Katie from Books and Things on Goodreads, and she just mentioned that she always feels like she's missing something in Virginia Woolf's books. And I feel the exact same way. I always feel like I'm missing something. There's some sort of metaphor that I didn't understand. And yeah, weird. But yeah, I finished it and don't recommend it, honestly. If you want to read it, if you like character-driven books, then do go ahead and pick it up, but it wasn't that good. So yeah, I am now going to pick up A Chunker, which I am pretty sure that I will not finish by the end of the readathon or the 24-hour readathon, but I'm gonna pick it up anyways because it's the other book that I have that Rory Gilmore has in her, yeah, that she has in her list. So it's Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. I know that JK Rowling is kind of canceled now, so I'm not gonna talk much about it, but that is a book that I'm gonna pick up. And yeah, let's see how far I get into it before I crash and burn. I'm not used to reading books in such a short amount of time, but I am glad that I finished this. I don't think I'm gonna pick up any of her books in the future because it's the second time that I have done it and I have gotten nothing but boredom out of it. And if, I mean, yeah. I'm gonna leave you guys for now, and I will update you guys when if maybe I finish this. I don't think I will, but we'll see. Hello everyone, it is 11:16 at night and I think I am going to log off for a while. I am very pleased with the results, and I know that they may seem very small, but I am a slow reader by heart. So I finished reading Mrs. Dalloway. I read this in one day. Again, I do think that it was very boring to me. It was very, yeah, I wasn't really invested in the story. So I think that if you have enjoyed previously Virginia Woolf, this book, you may enjoy it because I feel like her style is very similar. And the kind of stories that she tells throughout her books, they're very character driven. And I am pretty sure that there are tons of metaphors that I didn't get. So I think that this would be good to discuss with a class. But yeah, on my own, I didn't really enjoy it. And I started Harry Potter and the Goblet of Fire. I didn't make that much progress either. Again, really enjoying this. I'm having a really hard time just kind of knowing how to approach Harry Potter. I know that some booktubers have decided to write off the subject altogether, and I respect that. I'm having a hard time again figuring out how I will address it, but I want to make clear that everyone is welcome in this channel. Everyone is respected. Trans lives matter. Trans women are women. Trans men are men. So just that is where I stand. JK Rowling is not right. But there's a part of me, and I hate to say, but there's a part of me that just loves Harry Potter. But we have to understand that there is a significant, I guess, that in a way talking about the subject is kind of supporting the author. And again, I didn't want to have this discussion in this vlog, but I think that I would love to hear your feedback and your suggestions, because it is a delicate subject, especially for the many fans who have grown up with this story and who love it and who care so much about the characters. Yeah, I am open to your suggestions. It's something that I am still kind of working my head around, and I'm trying not to really talk about the books or the author at all. It's just something that in the circumstance of today, this was one of the books that I wanted to pick up. So yeah, I'm gonna leave it here, I think. And but since I don't want to make this, I feel like this vlog was very empty and very boring, I want to talk about some of the books that I want to be reading in the future, in the upcoming month. So of course we have Harry Potter, I have Dune, because the audiobook appeared in my the hold that I had in my library is up, so I can finally read this with the audiobook, because I feel like this one I will need it. And I also started The Water Dancer by Ta-Nehisi Coates. This book has the best first chapter I have ever read. I read this first chapter and I was just so invested in the story. I was so invested. I was in it. I was lost in the story. The writing is beautiful. I have a feeling that this book will be a favorite. So I had to stop because the Rory Gilmore 24-hour readathon began, but in the next couple of weeks, these are the books that I'm going to be reading. So yeah, they're all kind of chunkers, so wish me luck. But yeah, thank you guys for watching. Hopefully you enjoyed this very random and badly filmed vlog. I'm not very good at vlogs, but yeah, I hope that you enjoyed all the same, and thank you guys for watching, and I will see you guys with the next video.